Hey y'all, y'all come on in the room. It is simply amazing how people go tune in for the messy, honey. Well, I'm in y'all. So let me. Come on in the building, boo. Let's get it. Let's go.
I was gonna zero in on that.
Gotta tell the judge this. That'll be at least 10 minutes worth of deflection.
I'm trying to keep from talking about this lawsuit because you know that I'm gonna hang on to that. But you're a porno star.
And ain't nothing wrong. People can do what they want. But if that's who you are, that's who you are. And I want to know the truth. You're a porno star.
Yes, you can follow me on Instagram. I'm Peaches Pop Singer 100.
You keep telling me to follow you, Pop Singer 100.
That's my Peaches Pop Singer 100.
Well, you look first and tell me. Pop Singer 100. Lovely Peaches Pop Singer 100, y'all. All right. What else you want to tell me?
So basically, I grew up in the Bronx. I'm from the Bronx.
You got me thrown off. You threw me off.
From New Orleans, crawfish has always been like a big comfort for me. It's like my favorite food. Like, I'm addicted to crawfish. And basically, I was in this group chat with the defendant, and I told him about how I haven't been able to find crawfish during the COVID days because there's such a shortage of it. And he told me that he owns a seafood place and that he will send me crawfish.
Where do you all know each other from?
A group chat.
Okay. How's the group compiled?
We've been there for a long time. Basically, we talk about games we play. We're both in a club, Penguin. So basically, a few of us, we just talk, we're going through stuff. And we're kind of like friends, online friends. So he told me he owns a...
How'd you all meet? How'd you get into this chat?
On Club Penguin, there's like a live chat where you can talk to people, and we gave each other's Instagrams.
I'm just trying to figure out, I'm not necessarily trying to be nosy into your business as much as I am trying to understand how the social media interactions occur. I know about Instagram, I know about Facebook, and then I think there's an Instagram Live. I'm familiar with that. A couple other things I might be familiar with. Chat room. I don't know how that is created. People come together with a common purpose or commonalities, and so they get on and they chat from time to time. Is that what a chat room is? People with common interests get on there and talk about the same thing. So you and your friends, y'all got a sex fiend chat thing or porno chat? And you talking about how you don't have the porn in your heart?
I'm not lucky. I didn't get the porn group chat. So.
Let me get some background for you. You've been patient.
Don't go away. More judgment. This is coming up.
All right, y'all. So that is the first part. Y'all coming on up in the room. Make sure y'all are liking and following that girl's stuff. Do you hear me? Let's go ahead and get this thing fast forwarded. Can y'all hear okay? Throw the horse in the air if y'all can hear okay.
I'm not as interesting as you are, but we met in the club, Penguin Group Chat, and she is wild. She is wild.
She's just not making this up. She is.
Wow, she's exotic. She is spectacular. I guess like she's gone like door to door to these, you know. And you say you don't know much about social media. You're an influencer.
Yeah.
She'll go door to door to these influencers and just hang out with them. Just like interrupt whatever they're doing. Finds out their address. Whatever. Like, hey, what's up? And they're like, oh, and then let her in because they know who she is. And she is, I don't even know how to explain it. But she's spectacular.
At what?
At being wild. There's no one else like her.
Don't you have to be in their person to know that they're spectacular when they're wild?
Well, I mean, honestly,
I'm trying to be short of promiscuity or alleging there's some sexual, because you can do porno and not be a sex fiend. But if you say you keep saying how she's so wild, you give me the impression she's a wild, out of control sex fiend.
I know
that.
Right?
Needs to be reeled in by a judge to a judge.
Oh.
So
that's a great scene. That'd be a great scene.
I'm trying to get it down there, but it just seems like you're supposed to have a mind of its own.
But no, what's her response here? Seriously, when I met her, she is very polite, calm, reserved, and then you go online and she's like screaming like a child over God knows why. Like, I don't even know. Like everything that she does is just insane. But in person, total opposite. Very nice person, very kind. Soft spoken.
What's the screaming part?
I can't even come up with what she's screaming about because there's probably like 8 million of them online. What I'm trying to say is she is an attention freak.
Well, sounds like you're a freak, period. Porno and all the beyond porno.
Whatever subject she can dabble, you know, she does music, you know, every little thing that she can get into, that's what she's going to do.
And that's all right.
I don't blame her. If you can afford to do that, go right ahead. Unfortunately, most of us can't afford after adulthood to do that. As young people with families or young people who can get supported by somebody else, yeah, you can dibble and dabble and dibble and dabble. But when it's time to go to work, ain't no dibbling and dabbling unless you have a support system that'll provide that. But you have, what do you take, about an hour? I take like 12 hours a day.
All time.
How much you take? How long is what's your tape day like?
Just when I feel like it.
When you feel like it. How many hours? Let's see if I can get a new contract. On your show, you can do whenever you can take it whenever you want, and there's no minimum time.
I'm not supposed to, I feel like it.
Well, she, you know, she is a brand. You know, she is.
I'm a real.
Okay. But people.
You know, why does. Go ahead.
People just watch her just for her, nothing else. They like the craziness.
Somebody like that porno, or she wouldn't keep doing it.
Someone likes it, yeah.
A lot of men?
Yeah.
Okay, a lot of men like full-figured ladies, and so don't think just because she's full-figured that she doesn't have a lot of attraction in the porno industry. So thank you for sharing that you have men that are attracted to you to view your pornographic situations. Is that a good way to say it?
Yeah.
I still go to heaven.
Yeah.
So it is very interesting now, to say the very least. So the crawfish, and you wanted the crawfish. What was the agreement on the crawfish that you're suing him about?
So basically, I sent him $2,000. I told him just send the crawfish what he can. Whatever that would be worth, you know, just send me a line of crawfish. And it was basically a deposit. And, yeah.
You said send me $2,000 worth of crawfish. Aren't those like the crawfish are little?
Yeah.
So how many pounds or cases would that be, 2,000?
I bet you just put trust in him to deal with that.
Yeah, I'm just curious. What did you expect, though? You have to have an expectation. Say, I'm going to have me 10 boxes of crawfish, or I'm going to have enough crawfish. crawfish to last me for a month if I eat it every day, you had to have some type of expectation when you get a man in 2000. He says, I'm going to bring you back 30 pounds. I have no idea. 50 pounds, 100 pounds. I don't know what you would get for $2,000 when you're purchasing crawfish. But you should have, before you give him your 2000, what did you expect back?
I expected it to last me through the whole COVID thing. Yeah.
Did you all have a discussion about how much he would bring back?
On the receipt, it either says 100 or 1,000.
Pounds?
Pounds. She has the receipt. I can't remember all of it, but it's 100 or 1,000.
Judge Mathis gives the verdict when we return.
All right, y'all. Well, we are wrapping it up. As y'all coming in, make sure y'all are liking and following the girl page, honey. I ain't pressing another play button until we get this all the way up. We need them followers up. We need them likes up. I'm going to give y'all 2 minutes, baby. Run it up, run it up, run it up. Share because you care. Invite because you like. Oh, Lord. Y'all miss. How y'all gonna debo me out my episode?
Wednesday night on Fox 44 News.
All right, y'all.
Your ex refuses to pay. Call 1-888-VERDICT.
Key Dallas, like, girl, don't block me. I need to hear the rest of it now. Here we go, y'all.
Wade Willie is being sued by a woman he met in the chat room, who admits she's an online influencer who also does adult videos.
What was the agreement? Well, you have the receipt. I'm gonna have to look at that because this isn't making sense. 100 or 1,000 for the same amount of money?
I just can't remember.
Okay, all right. I understand now. Quantity 1. Delivery remaining balance 1. All right, ma'am, you didn't know what you were supposed to get. Maybe that isn't relevant, then. If you don't know how much you were supposed to get, and I'm giving you minutes to look it up, and you still can't tell me you how much you expected for $2,000. So what happened to your
$2,000? Basically, I've never received anything, no kind of crawfish.
When were you to receive it? Was there a deadline?
No, there wasn't. I told Wade to get it to me when he can. This happened over a year ago, actually. So I told him to give it to me when he can. I tried not to bother him too much, but after not hearing from him for a long period of time, I started contacting him, asking him where it's at. He started saying that he still didn't have any yet. He even offered to send other type of seafoods like crabs, octopus, and I said, no, that's not what I paid for it.
Okay, sir, let me hear from you.
I told her that
$2,000. She can't tell me or show me how much she expected to receive from you, but nonetheless, you tell me what you believe the transaction to have been.
It was either 100 or 1,000 pounds, but I was told by my suppliers that I could be able to deliver the crawfish, but my policy is I do not do refunds. I can do exchanges. But I was unfortunately not able to do crawfish, but like she said, I was able to do others.
And what did she say about others?
No, thank you.
Right?
No, thanks.
Right. So, one, if you're doing this for a living, you know how much 100 costs, and you know how much 1,000 costs, and you know how much money you receive. So for you to say you don't know it was either 100 or 1,000, yet you know the amount of money you received to purchase it, so you knew what it would get. If you didn't, then you're not very experienced at that business. That's what I would have to otherwise conclude.
I would have to agree I'm not very experienced. I was just handed this company from my family.
This is the first transaction?
No, not mine. I've never done crawfish before.
Pardon?
I've never had a crawfish purchased before, but
so you didn't know what to tell her she would get for $2,000.
Right, but I was promised.
And you didn't know what to expect for $2,000.
I'm sorry.
She didn't know what to expect for $2,000. You didn't know what you'd be able to buy her for $2,000, right? All right, and so reason you don't want to give her money back is because you don't provide refunds even for things that you are unable to deliver.
Yes.
Refunds are when you get something and you want to take it back. She never got anything for her money, other than somebody who took her money and gave her nothing and said, I'll give you a pair of socks or whatever it is you offered her in exchange. It certainly wasn't crawfish. Did he offer you crawfish to exchange?
He offered me crab and octopus. I don't even know how to eat that.
Correct. And I'm not sure why you think you could give somebody a totally different product, sir. All right, and you don't even know how much $2,000 to buy when you go and buy it. Okay, I'm going to make sure we don't say your business name because we don't want to hurt your business. If anybody watching this and see what type of business you do, they're going to say, just like you said, you're not experienced, and certainly your business practices don't measure up. $2,000 is your judgment. You gave him $2,000 to get a specific item. He said he's not giving you your money back because they don't have the specific item, and you won't take what he wants you to have. I ain't got that. Take this. I don't want that. That's not what I ordered. It is. Say it. That gives me an allergy. I don't care about no allergies. Crab allergies. Yeah, take it. So, no. When you come to me, I'll stop all that. As we have. Judgment for the plaintiff. Good luck to you. Go on, look at that site. Just keep